1 month after construction of the 30-meter telescope was brought to a halt, big news from the governor's office.
In the meantime, however, TMT has the right to proceed with construction.
Today, Governor Ige acknowledged that mistakes were made during this process, but says that must change now moving forward. We wanted to know what this announcement means for the state and other parties involved. So Sarah Yorrell went to get answers. Sarah?
Joe, there's no doubt this has been a very heated topic, but the governor believes that science and technology can coexist with culture atop Mauna Kea.
Whether you see it from a cultural perspective or from a natural resource perspective, we have not done right by a very special place, and we must act immediately to change that.
After much discussion with the University of Hawaii, community leaders, and other stakeholders, Governor David Ige has called for a plan of action. Governor Ige says the University of Hawaii needs to do a better job in its stewardship of the mountain moving forward. He even gave the school a list of his expectations. That list includes a request to decommission as many telescopes as possible, with at least 25% of all telescopes gone by the time TMT is up and running.
If we are going to be a long-term partner and landlord with the University of Hawaii, we expect the university to do its part as well.
We agree that the university can and must do better, and we apologize for where our efforts have fallen short to date.
Governor Ige is also looking to establish a Mauna Kea Cultural Council, which would work with the state to make sure the mountain is properly managed.
I think he's made another big mistake. I think he's misreading the Hawaiian community entirely on this issue. And his resolve to, you know, enforce the right of these people to go ahead and build the TMT is going to cause another escalation on that mountain.
This afternoon, TMT released this statement saying, "We appreciate that there are still people who are opposed to the project, and we will continue to respectfully listen and work with them to seek solutions." There's no word yet on when construction will resume atop Mauna Kea. We will continue to track this and let you know of any developments. Sarah Yorrell, KHON2 News.